If you have to call your friend, can you call your friend without a name? No, you need to call name of your friend. Similarly, we must assign name to every organism. This is called nomenclature. Assigning name to an organism is called nomenclature. To understand the concept of nomenclature, we will see some examples. So students, every day you meet many people, including family members or friends or teachers or your neighbors, etc. Each one of them has a specific name. We usually follow a system of using name and surname. So in a family, all members have same surname, but first name of each person is different. For example, Mr. Anand Kamat and his family members. Now let's assume that Mr. Anand has three children, namely Shirish, Siddharth and Madhavi. Hence, their names would be Shirish Anand Kamat, Siddharth Anand Kamat, Madhavi Anand Kamat. Children of Shirish and Siddharth will use surname Kamat, but Madhavi's surname will be different after getting married. On the other hand, if people are not related, their names and surnames both are different. For example, neighbors of Kamath family are, say, Reddy and Kulkarni. Obviously, these families are not related with Kamath family and hence their names and surnames will be different. So students, using name and surname, it is possible to identify a person correctly. Now we can use same method to identify organisms. Organisms have common names or vernacular names. For example, brinjal. This plant has other common names like wanga or bangan, eggplant, etc. It means one plant has more than one names. Now this will create confusion while studying that plant. Therefore, Carl Linnaeus started a system of nomenclature which is more scientific. He started using two words in the name of organism. This is called binomial nomenclature. Students, do you know that Linnaeus alone has given names to almost 10,000 organisms? For this important contribution, he is called father of taxonomy. So now we will see some important rules of binomial nomenclature. It makes use of two words in the name. While writing classification, genus and species are the last two words. They indicate name of organism. First word is genus and second word is species. The words are taken from Greek or Latin languages. If handwritten, underline both words. If printed, the font is italics. The first letter of genus is always capital. In species name, all letters are in small case. In this video, we have seen the limitations of using common names to identify organisms. Therefore, binomial nomenclature system was introduced by Carl Linnaeus. Students, now you are also familiar with the rules of binomial nomenclature. Hence, hereafter try to find scientific names of different organisms around you. Also follow this system of nomenclature while writing their names. Now students, there is a small exercise for you. Identify genus and species from following examples. First one, Salmonella typhi. Second one, Hibiscus rosa sinensis. So students, verify your answers. In Salmonella typhi, genus is Salmonella and species is typhi. In Hibiscus rosa sinensis, genus is Hibiscus and species is Rosa sinensis.